Hey everyone, welcome to the channel, and in this video I'm going to be talking about how you can become an AR/VR developer. So the first thing that I want to mention here is that this question, that how to become an AR/VR developer, is actually too vague and very broad. And I say this because to get started in AR/VR, you should have some sort of knowledge in development, in general development. So you'll understand what I'm trying to say once you check out the whole video. So what I've done is broken down this video into three parts. That is, how to become an AR/VR developer as a web developer, as a mobile developer, and as a game developer. Let's get started with number one. How to get started in AR/VR as a web developer. As a web developer, I guess you already have enough knowledge of HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. Those are like basics, right? Now, it's not important that you need to know a framework like React or Angular, all right? If you know, that's great. If you don't know, that's okay as well, okay? Now, the next part is to jump into something called 3.js. And you build websites using 3.js, okay? And one course that I recommend to everyone for 3.js is the course by Bruno Simon. So I've already made a video on it regarding the whole, you know, how it is and how good it is. So you can check out that video if you want to. So now you have a good understanding of 3.js. Now you want to dive into something called WebXR, okay? So there's a WebXR API by Google that you can check out. And I tried it out myself. And I combined 3.js and the WebXR API to make something like this that you can see on the screen right now. Okay, now that's what it is in a nutshell. Like, you know HTML, CSS, JavaScript, and now you know 3.js, and now you know how to combine WebXR, okay, with 3.js. Now, obviously, you can go a step further and dive into the frameworks, React.js. You can combine React.js, 3.js, and WebXR together with something called React 3. So React 3is, I haven't used it yet, so I'm not sure. I am still, you know, midway through React.js. I'm not very good at it or anything. I'm just learning the basics right now. So anyway, you can, if you already have a good knowledge of React, most probably you can check it out, because I've seen so many developers who are already talking about React 3 and, you know, combining React 3 with augmented reality and doing some amazing stuff. One thing to note over here is that the WebXR API, it most probably doesn't work for iPhones. It works only for Android phones. And I don't know why is that, because I've just heard this. I haven't tested it out because I don't have an iPhone. Like, I just got to know it from one of my friends in the XR community. So if you want to go and try it out, go ahead. Let's see if it is actually working or not, and let me know down in the comments below. So I guess that would make it easier for any web developer to get started in AR/VR now. And let's jump to the next track. So as a mobile developer, you probably already have experience in either Android development or iOS development, right? And for the people who use Flutter, I'm not going into that topic for now, but let's just focus on native mobile development for now. That is iOS development and Android development. If you're developing iOS applications, you can create augmented reality apps using something called ARKit. And ARKit is one of the SDKs that you can use to develop AR applications in iOS. Now, if you already have experience in Android, you can get started with AR Core. Earlier, we used to have this tool called SceneForm that actually allowed us to visualize 3D models inside of Android Studio. But the problem now is that SceneForm is already deprecated, but the web page is still there. I don't know why it is so, but it's still there, and it's not being maintained anymore. So I have still tried it out myself, and I can't use SceneForm as easily as I used to when I explored it back in 2018. Yeah, there are also some more SDKs that are there. Like, there's one SDK that I would highly recommend. It's the Vero Core SDK. It's absolutely fantastic, and you can develop Android AR apps using native or using Vero Core. So while using Vero Core, you might face some difficulties while setting up the project, and you know, you have to import the Vero Core library as a module. So in fact, you also need to include AR Core as a module. So I'm not going to get into the technical side of it right now, because this video will become longer. If you actually want to get started with Vero Core, you can check out their website and you can check out the documentation, as well as you can check out their samples on the GitHub repository. And this would be a better approach. So I would say that, you know, clone the GitHub repo, the samples repo that they have created, and then try to understand how the structure of the project is. All right. So once you understand the project structure, you will be able to make the same thing in your own way. Like you can actually create it from scratch. But that's just my approach. You can try it out yourself. You can do whatever you want to. But that is how I learned when I was, you know, trying out Vero Core. So it is important to understand here that Vero Core actually internally uses AR Core, and a lot of the things that you would do inside with Vero Core, you can do with AR Core as well. But I would still recommend Vero Core, because I don't know, I just found it much more comfortable to use rather than going for AR Core. And using Vero Core, you will be able to change the look and feel of your models by changing the materials, by changing the lighting, and you know, by, you can even apply your own textures to your model. So there's a lot of things that you can do with Vero Core rather than going for AR Core at the moment. But if you just want to place a model on the, you know, in your scene, then you can definitely use AR Cores. There's something called Scene Viewer that you can use in AR Core. That is actually pretty easy to set up. It's just like around, what, 3 to 4 lines of code. You just launch an intent and you can do it. However, you cannot customize the look of your models by, you know, by changing the materials or the textures of your model. So that is why I go for Vero Core rather than, you know, sticking to AR Core. Okay, so as a game developer, you might be having experience in either Unity or Unreal. Now, game developers are actually at an advantage when it comes to developing AR/VR applications or AR/VR experiences. Why is that? It's because you already have the general understanding of 3D, all right, like 3D concepts, and that actually becomes very, very beneficial for you. So as a game developer, you already have good knowledge of, you know, vectors and basic 3D mathematics, as well as computer graphics, right? So all that will actually be very, very useful when you are developing any AR application or virtual reality application. I don't have experience with Unreal. I mostly have experience with Unity, and that is what I will talk about. So in Unity, you have a bunch of different SDKs related to what you want to do. So in case you want to go for augmented reality, you will go for AR Foundation, AR Core, AR Kit, Euphoria, Wikitude, there's so many. And if you want to go for virtual reality, it depends on the platform that you're choosing to develop your virtual reality applications for. So in case you are developing applications, VR applications for Oculus, you'll have to use the Oculus SDK. If you are developing applications for HTC Vive, you'll have to, you know, use the HTC Vive SDK. So you can see that it is becoming a bit complicated, right? Like there's so many different SDKs for AR and VR. So it becomes a bit difficult to manage everything. So this is actually being sorted out. There's something called OpenXR that is coming out, and I haven't got a chance to work with it. So that's the reason why I'm not able to tell you exactly how to use OpenXR or if you should use or not. Okay, so you can see that I'm recording now. It's like nighttime. The whatever you watch till now was recorded in the morning, and this part is being recorded in the night, so it's dark behind me, that's why. So anyway, I hope that doesn't, you know, matter that much. So I'll just jump to the good part. Any AR application that you develop or any AR experience that you develop, it works for platforms, for both the platforms, like iOS and Android, right? So that's like one of the major benefits of developing AR applications inside of Unity. Also, you get tons of customization features using just drag and drop interface, using a drag and drop interface inside of Unity, as well as it's much more simpler to customize the look and feel of your models using materials, shaders, and VFX, particle effects, and whatnot. So there's so many features of Unity, right? So as a game developer, you already know. And it's just think of it as, you know, you're just developing a game. So you're just developing a game, but that can be viewed in augmented reality. So also, it's really important to note here that AR game and AR application, they both are completely different. At least that is what I feel. And when you're developing AR application, you need a few more things, like, you know, connecting with the backend and writing code to connect with the backend, and, you know, fetching data from there, like just JSON parsing stuff, basic software development. But you know, on the other hand, if you are actually developing a game, you need to understand, you know, gameplay mechanics and how does physics work. So that's pretty different from how an AR application is developed and how an AR game is developed. So another thing to note here is that developing UIs inside Unity with those drag and, you know, the canvas element and UI button stuff, that I feel building UIs with those canvas elements can be a bit difficult. It's just because, like, I've already worked with Android development myself, so I find it much easier to develop UIs in Android rather than in Unity. So, but Unity is already evolving, and there's so many different things that are coming out. I mean, I've checked out UI Builder. It's actually very similar to how you develop UIs in Android. So it's kind of similar. You have all those different options on the right hand side, and with the views and customizing those views. So it's pretty much the same. But this is just something that is a constraint at the moment, but it'll just get better with time. So yeah, that's what I believe. So yeah. Alright, so that's it for this video, and I hope this makes it very this video makes it simpler for you to understand, as whatever role you have, that, you know, maybe a web developer, mobile developer, or game developer, you will be able to understand how to implement AR/VR in your domain. So yeah, that's it for this video, and I hope you liked it. And if you liked it, just hit the like button. And if you could share this video with your friends or whoever wants to, you know, get started with AR/VR, maybe as a web developer, game developer, mobile developer, whatever, just share it with them. If you have any other questions, you can just ask me down in the comments below. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button to stay updated with all the latest AR/VR news. Alright, thanks for watching till the end of this video, and cheers. Bye-bye.